Hello, my name is Rickard, and in this short tutorial, I want to give you some tips on how you can create rule of third or pie grid guide layouts in Photoshop. All right, let's go to File, Open, and in my assets here, got a couple of photos. I'm just going to open one of these from Jorge, and I want to create a rule of thirds grid, and that'll just allow me to kind of see where I want to put elements into a composite. Now, if you go to the crop tool in Photoshop, let's go ahead and reset this and actually start moving your crop, you're actually going to see that you have a thirds grid on there already, and you can change the grid here. So you've got the rule of thirds. You've got just the standard grid, you've got the golden ratio grid, and you can show those, and those really help when you're kind of cropping your image. If you want to know like where you should place objects, where they should be coming out of, this is always a really good indicator. It'll help make your compositions feel more grounded, just feel nicer and more balanced, I would say. So what I want to do is show you how you can create this grid as guides in your document. So back in the day, we would have to kind of do this all manually by, creating some blocks like this. Let's say I wanted to do a third. So I would create three blocks kind of different colors or different shades and use my guides to make sure they were all snapping together like that. And once I had three, I could then, move these together as a unit and go like this and then pull in some guides and snap them to those points. And that would be how I would create guides. Now, Photoshop has really improved on the ability to make guides of any kind. I want to show you how much easier it is than doing all this. So let's go ahead and go to our guides down here. I'm going to clear guides. And then we're going to go to this new guide layout. And this is something that they added in the last, I would say in the last 5 years, maybe even 3 years. And it's a really nice feature because it allows you to build these grids on your own. They already have a few here, but let's go ahead and build a rule of thirds. So that would be three here, three there with no margin. And we have our rule of third grids. We can also clear the existing guides as we put them or not, and we can add some center guides or center columns if we want. So let's hit okay there. You can see we've now created a grid like this. Now, what if we want to create a golden ratio grid? A golden ratio grid like this is 1, 1, 1 in terms of equal parts. With a golden ratio grid, it's 1.68. and then one. So we need to do some math to get there. And unfortunately, you can't really do that with the new guide layout. I found actually the easiest way to do this is to create a layer that's exactly the size of your canvas and then do Command T for transform. And we're gonna transform this to 23.4. And 23.4, if we now, well, let's actually clear our guides first. But if we now put guides on here, we have created a golden grid. And just to verify that it's that grid, we can go onto our crop tool, change this to the golden ratio here. And then you'll see our guides actually line up to that golden ratio perfectly. So that's a trick there on how to create the golden ratio. And I showed you how to do the rule of thirds. Now, personally, The three things that I use the most are rule of thirds, golden ratio, and the center guides. So what I've done for my workflow is I've turned those into actions. So I've got a rule of thirds grid action that creates my rule of third grid, another action that creates my golden ratio, and then the center guides, which just adds center guides. And this one, I intentionally made it not override the other two. So no matter what grids you already have in place, if you click on the center guides, it'll just add the center guides. If you want to get those actions instead of doing the steps by hand, I have included a link to those in the description of this video. It is a paid product, but obviously you can also create your own actions to do these things now that you know how to do it. So there you have it. That's how you create those grid lines or guide layouts in Photoshop. If you enjoyed this tutorial, please subscribe to my channel, leave a comment, leave a like. Here's some other videos to check out. I'll see you next time.